You know how they say champions are made in the off season? Well, they could almost say that vegans are made in the kitchen. Let's keep it easy. Hey guys, welcome back to Natural Vegan Mama. If you're new here, my name is Shantae. I'm a vegan coach. We're going to be talking about how to assess your kitchen and how to make sure you have the proper things that you need going forward to be successful as a vegan. But before we get started, this video is a part of a series. So if you haven't seen the videos before this one, definitely check them out. I'll leave them in the description box below. And make sure you subscribe so you don't miss the videos that are coming after this one. All of these videos I've put together so that you can be successful as a vegan. If you know someone that's thinking about going vegan, please share this with them and this will help them on their journey. So what happens when you hit this notification bell after you subscribe, you'll get a notification, a little pop-up, anytime I post a video. So it's kind of like having your own private vegan coach in your pocket. All right, guys, let's get started in 3, 2, 1, let's get started. So one of the most important steps to going vegan is assessing your kitchen. You can start by opening the cabinets, looking at the items that you have in those cabinets, and reading the ingredients. I find that a lot of people are pleasantly surprised when they discover that a lot of the items that they already have in their pantry, in the refrigerator, are actually vegan. So it's a good idea to go ahead and assess what you have, and that way you'll know what you need to start incorporating and purchasing and bringing into your kitchen. Hey guys, I just wanted to pop into the video really quick to let you know you can sign up for my newsletter. If you sign up for my newsletter on my website, naturalveganmama.com, you'll get recipes, tips, and you'll get your own private vegan coach delivered right to your email box. All right, enjoy the rest of the video. Bye. As you become a better nutrition label reader, you will discover a lot of items that you don't think have animal products in them actually do have animal products. So you'll find that some products have milk, and you'll start to say to yourself, why does this have milk in it? So it's really, really a great idea to look at those things and start to research and find out what are the other words that are being used for milk. Sometimes it won't say milk. So the next video in this series are 10 steps on how to meal plan. These are my tried and true steps. These really help me a lot when I'm meal planning, and I'm sharing them with you in the next video. So I'll see you in the next one. Bye.